everyone. I, Yogesh Rajian, Faculty of DLED Department from Tecnia Institute of Teacher Education, is going to deliver a lecture on computer-aided learning. Computer-aided learning, as the name suggests, it stands for the type of learning aided or carried out with help of computer as a machine. According to Bhatt and Sharma, CAL is defined as an interaction between a student, a computer-controlled display, and a response entry device for the purpose of achieving educational outcomes. CAL may be defined as a technique or method of instruction in which there is a purposeful interaction between a learner and computer device having useful instructional material as software for helping the individual learner to achieve the desired instructional objective with his own pace and ability at his command. Now let us discuss basic assumptions of CAL. Instructions for a number of learners at a time. It can serve at a time thousands of learners in an individualized way. What an individual needs according to his ability and interest in a particular subject or topic, he can get the needed instruction material and help from the computer. Automatic recording of the learner's performance. How does an individual learner react to the presented instructional material? What are his queries and difficulties? What is his performance in terms of learning outcome? All such things can be successfully and accurately recorded by a computer device in CAL. Variety in the use of methods and techniques. It assumes that every learner cannot be benefited through a single method, and all the subjects or topics in a subject cannot be handled through a common method or strategy. So in this, individual learner may choose a particular method or approach according to their own interest or ability or nature of the instructional material. Now let us discuss various modes of CAL. Information computer-aided learning. Computer can serve the role of an inquiry officer to respond to the student's inquiry with answers it has stored. The main purpose of this type of CAL is to provide essential information for the acquisition of concepts and skills. Drill and practice program. This type of CAL provides the learner different types of drill and practice programs covering specific topics related with a particular subject. Through such drill and practice program, the services of computer can be properly availed for providing practice in something already learned in some other way. Computer never gets tired and does not show anger on wrong response and provide answers and feedback within fractions of seconds. Tutorial type computer assisted instruction. They can play effectively the role of a tutor by maintaining a perfect interaction and dialogue with the individual students. Educational games type. The purpose of such type of games is to provide intellectual challenges, stimulation of curiosity, and serve as a source of motivation to the individual learners. Simulation type instruction. In such type of CAL, simulation is used as a technique for providing training to the students. With the carefully prepared programs, the students here are made to face real or idealized situation. Problem-solving type CAL. Here, learner has to find answers to a problem rather than given by the computer. Here, the students are provided with programs that can make them think about the ways and means of solving the problem systematically, for example, logo program of computer. Practical work-oriented learning. Such programs can provide valuable help in supplementing laboratory and other practical work. Student can learn so many things about the science experiments before actually performing them in his practical class by watching and following a computer program made for this purpose. Learning affairs and managing type instruction. Software programs provide valuable help in managing and supervising the learning affairs of the students. They can have a proper check over the learning activities of individual students by identifying the academic weakness of students, in the education of handicapped children, computer can play a leading role. Now let us discuss advantages of CAL. It proves better than all other aids in educating. It saves time and energy of learner. It is highly individualized teaching and instruction technique. It can be effectively used for achieving cognitive objectives. It provides immediate reinforcement to each response of the learner. It ensures better learning by students. They are greatly interested in such programs. The details of student learning can be recorded here. That helps in removing the error of students in a very scientific way. It involves psychological principle of learning. The students can retain learning material for a long time. Computer has lot of patience as compared to teachers. Computer never get fatigued or tired. Now there are some limitations also. So now let us discuss limitations of CAL. Introduction of CAL in classroom proves quite expensive and uneconomical in terms of educational returns. There is a potential danger for the children either to damage the machine or be damaged by it. Much of the difficulty is felt on account of unavailability or usability of educational software. Servicing of the hardware also causes a serious problem. Long working in front of computer leads to health hazard. No machine can ever match the human beings for effective interaction with the human being. Long hour working on computer is boring and tiring. So this was all about CAL. Hope you have understood the topic, computer aided learning. Thank you very much.